Hello and welcome to Getting Started with the SOFiSTiK Bridge and Infrastructure Modeler. In this video, I will show you how to create a parametric superstructure based on your axis alignment. The basis for our superstructure is a two-dimensional cross-section. This two-dimensional cross-section will have the measurements as you see them on the picture right now. We will create two single span girders based on this cross section. Our superstructure will run from placement number 1 to placement number 2, meaning from 10 meters stationing of our axis to 50 meters on our axis. There we will have a 10 centimeter gap, after which our second single span girder will start and move up to placement number 3 at 80 meters. Additionally, we want to have a height variation of our superstructure. This can be easily handled via variables. These variables are hosted by the main axis and can be assigned to a parameter of our two-dimensional cross-section. For example, the height of our superstructure elements. We will assign this height information according to the stationing of our axis and then assign it to our parameters in the cross-section family. In Revit, we already prepared our axis alignment. So we can simply move to the SOFiSTiK Bridge and Infrastructure Modeler app and continue with the superstructure. Superstructure allows us to sweep any two-dimensional cross-section into a superstructure along our axis alignment. I will start by clicking on Create and then selecting the axis. You can see that the program automatically highlights what it wants from us. Additionally, down here, Revit also always tells us what this input actually requires. So now I select the axis. Then this graphical interface opens up. Let me explain quickly. Up here, we can select a profile family. Those are the two-dimensional cross-sections that we can select. They are based on adaptive families in Revit, which are created two-dimensionally. We will use the SOFiSTiK Profile T-Beam family. I will simply select it here. Over here, we immediately see a preview of the selected family that will be swept along the axis. The parameter list over here is defined by the user while creating this two-dimensional cross-section family. We can assign additional properties to them as well. Down here, you can see a from and a to value. This is where we can tell the program from placement number 1 to placement number 2 to sweep our cross-section into a superstructure. In the description, we have one single span girder from placement 1 to 2, and then we have a gap, and we continue from placement 2 to 3, meaning that we need to select an additional offset at placement number 2. This is what we can assign in here, and I will simply set it to -0.05. Down here, I can assign a material to the superstructure that we create. I can come into here and select concrete as the main material. I could also assign a category to it, but I will just leave it as generic model for now. I could also include the rotation of placements. With this option, I could create an angled cutoff of my superstructure. And down here, I can assign additional properties as well as specific functionalities of the program. Keep in mind, you can always press F1 within this program and the corresponding SOFiSTiK online documentation will open up and you can read up on what's actually happening with the input you give to the program. I will click on OK, and keep in mind, if I have this process immediately assigned here, the program will immediately create the superstructure. I can now use the view cube to take a closer look at it from the top. Let's zoom into placement number 1 where we can see that it intersects perfectly with the placement. And then when we zoom into placement number 2, we can see that there is now an offset which is considered by the program. We can also, when we move in 3D, just double check with the position of our placement number 2 that this is now 5 centimeters. We can now use an additional command of superstructure, the duplicate command, to simply take all the presets from this superstructure and assign it to another superstructure back here. I will select the original superstructure, and here you can now see that the placement number 1 is selected, placement number 2 is selected, and if we were to change any values over here, they would also be assigned to this superstructure now. It's basically a copy command. I will now just change from placement number 1 to placement number 2 and placement number 2 to placement number 3. And I will get rid of the minus 0.05 offset at the end of our superstructure. And I will assign positive 0.05 to the beginning of our superstructure. With a simple OK, the program will automatically create the superstructure. If we take a look at it from the side now, we can see that we have a perfect 10 centimeters offset in between those two superstructures. Now it is time to also include our variation of the height of our superstructure. To do that, we need to add additional information to our axis, which means that I want to go to the axis command of the SOFiSTiK Bridge and Infrastructure Modeler app and select the edit command. The edit command requires me to select an axis, select it, and now I don't want to change anything about the alignment. I want to add a variable. To create a new length variable, I need to use this dropdown over here and add a new variable via giving it a name like height and clicking on the plus sign. The program then allows me to select different unit types like an angle or a slope or a number, but for now we will stay with a length input. You can see here that the stations for the starting point, every placement and the end point of the axis are automatically assigned. We can of course always just select the last empty row and double click into it to create a new intersecting point. What we want to create is the following. We want to start at station number 10 with 1.2 meters. Continue at station number 11, by the way, I can just double click into an already used variable and it will be reassigned to the new station value that I assigned to it. So here you can see I selected 11 meters instead of 0. I want to assign it to 1.2 meters. I want to have another point at 30 meters along my axis, which will now be assigned to 2.2 meters. And I will continue on with 49, 1.2 meters. Next up is 51 with 1.2 meters again. Next up 65, 2.2, 79 with 1.2 meters. And last but not least, 80 meters with 1.2 meters. Up here, we can see a preview of the variation of length that we assigned to the stationing value of our axis. I do want this transition to not be a polygonal transition. So here you can see that here is actually a corner point and two linear polygons are connecting to it. This is something that I can very easily modify via our transition settings. I want to start with my station number 11, where I want it to transition gradually to the right side of the selected point. And once I enter the variation, you can immediately see a change. I want this point to be a high point, which is horizontal. So I want it to transition on both sides of this point. Here you can see I now get a perfectly aligned horizontal point here. This point should have a variation to the left, or a transition to the left of the point, and the right one to the right. And here I just repeat the same input. This is going to be a high point, and this one is supposed to transition to the left. Once I click on OK, the values are written into the axis. Nothing major actually changes, but if we now select the superstructure, and over here we can edit the superstructure, or we could go to superstructure and use the edit command in here, select the superstructure. I can now go to the value for my height in total and change it from a constant variation, meaning a constant value which defines the height of the section, to a variable. Why does the superstructure know that now there is a variable available? Because the superstructure itself is based on this axis, meaning that it reads additional information from this axis. So when I click on variable, I can now select here in the variable dropdown, my height variable. And you can see that this button over here is now not gray anymore, it's black. And we can use it to preview what's happening to our cross section along the stationing of our axis. I can click on OK, and the program will now interpolate a perfectly accurate superstructure for us with this variation of the height. I do want to assign the same thing for my second slab over here. So I select it, edit superstructure, and I can assign this height variable the same way I did it with the first single span girder. Meaning that the workflow always goes from adding additional information to the axis and then tell specific parts of your structure to have this variation assigned to them. Thank you very much for watching. In the next video, I will create the substructure with you.